with the optimal option, therapeutic option, so that we can continue for the best care of the patients.
Thank you. Dr. Rawas, I just wanted to ask you, being part of the POEM group which we heard about now, what are the strategies or the common strategies that you are using to have the same or the best care for your pediatric oncology among all people involved in this group?
Thank you, Dr. Ali. First, I would like to thank Dr. Solh and the CCCL team for their kind invitation for participation in this important meeting. POEM stands for Pediatric Oncology of East and Mediterranean Group. As Dr. Sima has alluded previously in her presentation, it was established 2013. With the collaboration and support from St. Jude Children's Research Center. The main aim or the mission was to improve care for children with cancer in the region through different modalities. They started initially with trying to support the diagnosis and treatment through online tumor board. So if you have a case, difficult case, you need an expert opinion, there's a monthly tumor board that you can present your case where it could be shared with experts, including experts from the region as well as from St. Jude. The second wave was establishing capacity, building capacity within the region, and that is something unique about POEM and the collaboration with St. Jude. Building the capacity within the region. Initially, we started with started with survey of assessment of needs in the region, and sort of to categorize, because the region is quite wide. You have different category of countries, from wealthy to middle income and lower income countries. So you need to see how you can mobilize your resources between the areas. So building capacity through workshops and also through actually establishing training spots in the established accredited centers. And this is the current strategy, and I think with what we see with the future strategic plan with the global St. Jude initiative would be.
So Sima, how many groups you have the POEM for the Eastern Mediterranean? So they are like seven.
So for now there are four main groups, as I mentioned, in Latin America, Mexico, and China, and then POEM is the fourth regional group. But we are starting with one in Russia and in Africa. And as I mentioned, we might have specific ones for India if we start having more centers. So really the idea is there will be the regional group, but they will all be a network. And you know, maybe you will want to check how this population compares to Latin America, and with the common database, it will be easy to do that. So the idea is to open the door to all countries to work together, because you asked me about how St. Jude contributed. So as we are advancing, we know now that cancer, even leukemia, is not one disease, and we are doing whole genome analysis on every child that comes to St. Jude now, and we are discovering all those subtypes. And what's important is not just that they have a specific gene signature, but that this gene signature affected can be targeted with specific treatment that improve the outcome. So the more cases we have, the more we can study those, because if every country or center work alone, they will never have enough cases to understand better the biology.
Thank you, Sima. So Miguel, you discussed the you started with the American guidelines to have a cancer center, and you ended with centers in the developing country. But what would be, in a very simple way, what are the minimum needed to have at least a cancer center that could give the best care for those patients. يعني since Seema talked about now, let's say Syria, Iraq, and what are the minimum things that we could give for countries who are unable to give the whole multidisciplinary supportive care for the?
The minimum is what I presented in the last slide. They have to have patient care, and the patient care, you know, has to have all the components. You know, now, if you don't have radiation oncology, you're going to miss on treating about half your patients. So again, if you have a country that has nothing, but trained physicians, trained nurses, trained pathologists, and a trained surgeon. And this is critical, in addition to good data keeping and a quality improvement program, because then you can build on that. But if you don't have training, it's also very important that you have to have, especially in these countries, buy-in from the government and private public partnership, because otherwise there will be no funding for these centers.
So Seema, in St. Jude, is there a training programs for all the, for example, let's take POEM and all those countries involved, and within the same country you might have different centers, even in the same country you might have different financial support for the center. So is there any training that the St. Jude can give, train free of charge, let's
yes,
say,
yes,
to
all
these?
So what the POEM, one of POEM initiative, is we understand that training is very important, and not everyone can go to St. Jude, because what we do at St. Jude doesn't really apply to the region. Also, sometimes there is the culture or language barrier.
They learn to train.
So what they did is they screened the whole region and identified 6 training centers, and those are in Lebanon, Jordan, Cairo, Saudi Arabia, Turkey, and India. And if you go to their website, you see an application, and the applicant, who can be either a fellow or a nurse or a surgeon, applies. They need a letter of recommendation from their medical director, because we need to train them so they go back to serve the region. And it's kind of competitive in the sense of where the needs are the most needed. And then St. Jude, POEM chooses, because the leadership is for them. They know the region. But after they choose, they come to St. Jude to get the final approval. And St. Jude provides the scholarship based on the living cost and the training at the site. We want them to be paid the same as the regular trainee, to be fair. And there is actually now a fellow from Syria training in Beirut, and a fellow from Gaza training in KHCC. And the idea, they will go back to Damascus and to Gaza. And this is how you help with the tears.
Yeah.
So this network is already established. St. Jude is already supporting it and will continue to build on it, inshallah.
Thank you. So I think, do we have more time? Or? So not really, no time.
Yes.
So thank you. I would like to thank the panel and the attendees for this, for listening to us and discussing these very important issues, especially in a world like us where we have a lot of problems. Thank you, and we'll go to panel 4.